Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to install the official EA app onto your Steam Deck. Installing the official EA app gives you access to any of the games that you may have purchased through that platform. It saves you from having to rebuy them on Steam, and in the case of some games, they might just not be available through the Steam platform at all. One warning is that this is not the smoothest experience. The EA app does not officially support Linux operating systems, which means we must run it through the Proton compatibility layer. To install this game store, we will need to change to desktop mode. You can do this by pressing the Steam button and then switching to the power option at the bottom. And then you'll want to click the switch to desktop option. Once in desktop mode, you'll want to open a web browser. In our case, we have Firefox installed to our Steam Deck already, so we'll be using that. With the web browser open, tap the address box at the top and press X to open the on-screen keyboard. You'll now want to type in https://www.ea.com/ea-app and then press R2 and then press B to close the on-screen keyboard. Once you're on the EA app website, click the download the EA app button. On the next page, you'll want to then click the Windows button. After the EA app installer has finished downloading to your Steam Deck, you will want to close out of the web browser and then double click the Steam icon on your desktop. Our next step is to add the EA app installer that we just downloaded as a non-Steam game. To do this, click the Add Game button in the bottom left corner, and then click the Add a Non-Steam Game button. This allows it to run under the Steam Proton compatibility layer. In the window that pops up, click the Browse button. And then switch to the Downloads directory using the sidebar, and then select the EA App Installer.exe and double click it. With the installer now selected, click the Add Selected Programs button. We will now want to run the installer that we just added to our Steam library, so switch to the library menu and then tap the search box, press X to bring up the keyboard and type in EA app with no spaces. And then press B to close the on-screen keyboard. Now select the entry called EA app installer.exe. Now before we can install this, we will need to enable compatibility mode so that it runs under Proton. We can do this by clicking the cog on the right hand side of the screen and then clicking the properties option. You'll now see a new screen. On this, you want to click the compatibility tab and then you'll want to click the force the use of a specific Steam Play compatibility tool checkbox. Then use the select box underneath to select Proton Experimental. The experimental branch is where the latest fixes are typically pushed. Once done, click the X button to close out the properties screen. You'll now want to click the play button to begin installing the EA app to your Steam Deck. With the installer now running, click the Let's Go button to install the EA app to your Steam Deck. The installation can take a couple of minutes, but we have sped it up for this video. Once installed, you'll be greeted by the sign in to your EA account screen. We will do this later, so click the X button for now. Our next step is to reconfigure our EA app installer.exe library entry so that it points to the EA app desktop client that we just installed. We must do it this way to ensure everything is run within the same Proton compatibility layer. To do this, click the cog icon and then click the properties button. Now let's start this section by renaming the shortcut from EA app installer.exe to EA app. Remember, you can bring up the keyboard by pressing the X button and then close it using the B button. Our next step is to click the Browse button to change the launch target. On here, click the Settings button and then click the Show Hidden Files option. The directory we require is a hidden folder and won't be shown by default. Now use the sidebar to change back to your home directory. And then double click the .local directory. Then double click the share directory and then scroll down and select the folder called Steam. And then next scroll and find the Steam apps folder and open that. Then the next directory we want is the compat data one. We now need to find the Proton directory that belongs to the EA app that we just installed to our Steam Deck. The easiest way to do this is to sort by date with the arrow pointing down. This means newer folders will be at the top of the list. Assuming the EA app was the last thing installed, double click the folder at the top of this list. Next, double click PFX, and then drive underline C, and then program files, and next you'll want the electronic arts folder, and then EA desktop, and then EA desktop again. Now within this folder, scroll down until you find the eadesktop.exe file, click it, and then click the open button. With the target directory now set, we will also need to set the starting directory. To save us a bunch of hassle and stress, double click the target text box and then press the left trigger or right click and then select copy. Next, highlight all the text in the starting text box and then press the left trigger or right click and then click the paste button. Now navigate to the end of the starting text box and remove the reference to eadesktop.exe. This should be roughly 13 presses of the backspace button. Now, our next step is to add a double quote to the start and end of both of these lines. We need to do this as spaces cause issues with paths on Linux. Before you add the double quotes to the starting directory, double click it to select all the text, then press the left trigger and then select the copy button. We will need this directory later to make a step a little simpler. Once done, add the double quote to the start and end of the starting text box. Once that is all set, click the X button to close out the properties menu. Our next step is to create a directory where our EA games will be stored on our Steam Deck. Essentially, what we are doing here is creating a directory that's outside of the Proton compatibility layer. This means if the layer ever gets deleted, your games will still be safe. To start this process, open the File Explorer by clicking the folder icon in the taskbar. With Dolphin now open, change to your home directory. Now right-click or press the L1 trigger, and then hover over the Create New option and then click Folder. Press X to bring up the on-screen keyboard and then type in a new name for this folder. For this tutorial, we'll be calling ours EA Games. Once set, click the OK button to create the folder. You now want to click the Split button in the top right corner, then double click Home, then highlight the selected path, and then press the left trigger and then click Paste. Once set, click the Tick button to change to your EA Desktop folder. We don't quite want this folder, so select Electronic Arts, then drive underline C. Now from the left hand side, click and drag the EA Games folder to the right. When prompted, click Link here. What this just did was create a symbolic link between the folder we just created and the drive underline C folder within the Proton directory. This will make the game folder easily accessible from within the EA app. We will now want to return to gaming mode by double tapping return to gaming mode in the top left hand corner. Now that you're back in gaming mode, bring up the Steam menu by clicking the Steam button on your Steam Deck and then select the library option. Within your library, change to the non-Steam tab using the R1 button. Within this screen, you should now see an application listed as EA App. Select it to continue. To launch EA App on our Steam Deck, all we need to do now is click the play button. Now follow the prompts to log into your EA account. If you don't see a keyboard, try clicking off of the text box and then double clicking it. Alternatively, you can also try pressing the Steam button and then X. The first time that you load up the EA app on your Steam Deck, you'll find that it takes a while to load properly. Once you're ready, we'll first start off by changing the default install directory to the folder that we created earlier. To access this, click the hamburger icon in the top left hand corner of the screen and then select the settings option. Next, change to the download tab and then click the edit button next to install location. On this pop-up screen, you should see a folder called EA Games at the top under your C drive. select it, and then click the OK button. With that done, we have now successfully set up the EA app on your Steam Deck. To show you that this all works properly, let us now install a game from the EA app to our Steam Deck. One thing to be warned of is that not all of these games will actually run on your deck. We highly recommend searching up any game you want to install to ensure that it will actually work. For our example, we are going to install Mass Effect, which turns out doesn't actually run without any modifications. Here, you can see the EA app is using the default installation location that we use, followed by the game name. To proceed with the installation of your chosen game, click the Next button. You'll then be prompted about any terms and conditions you must accept to download and install this game. To proceed, click the Download button. Now, if you scroll to the top, you'll find the game that you just installed listed. Just because it's under the installed header doesn't mean it's necessarily actually installed yet. Installation speeds typically highly depends on the speed of your internet connection more than the Steam Deck. Once installed, you should see the play button appear, and all you need to do is click it to launch the game. You might see a message saying the game requires extra permissions. Press OK to proceed. Now, with our first example, you'll see that we run into a shader compiler error. Basically, without any workarounds, we won't be able to actually play Mass Effect this way. So let's try another game. This time, we will install and run the game Dungeon Keeper on our Steam Deck through the EA app. Hopefully at this point, you have managed to install the EA app to your Steam Deck. If you found this guide to be helpful, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.